Now that you have a basic understanding of the documentary hypothesis, scroll down and carefully read the two accounts of creation from the beginning of the book of Genesis. I've provided some comments to help you think through various textual issues, but I want you to pay special attention to the order of creation, because this is where we see the greatest difference between these two versions of creation. This should help you to understand why scholars have developed this documentary hypothesis to try and account for how we could have two very different versions of creation, despite the traditional assumption that the text is written by a single person, Moses, under divine inspiration. After you've thought through the difference between these two versions of creation, I've provided a paragraph on the concept of cognitive dissonance, which is an idea about the discomfort that we feel when we are challenged with new information that contradicts previously held beliefs. For those of you who believe that the Bible is a divinely inspired text, you may be feeling something like this cognitive dissonance, a feeling that you may have thought that the Bible was one kind of text, and now perhaps new information is challenging that. But even if you don't believe that the text is divinely inspired, it's still an important thing for you to think about. You should certainly imagine what it would be like to have that feeling of having your beliefs challenged. And as we go through the course, everyone will have some of their previously held beliefs challenged. And so to think in advance about how we might respond to that cognitive dissonance. Do we reject a previously held belief and just replace it with a new one? Or perhaps we find a way to accommodate both beliefs. We merge them into a new set of beliefs that that is more coherent. Or else perhaps you just ignore the dissonance entirely and you just sort of move on and don't think about that issue. They're all viable responses. And it's up to each of us to decide how we want to deal with those kinds of issues. When you're done, at the bottom of the page, you'll see a question for you to write your reflection paper on. So it's a short reflection paper, just one page, but I want you to think through the various different issues that came up when you were reading these two accounts of creation and try and summarize it into a short answer and then post it onto Blackboard. Good luck, and I'll look forward to discussing this with you in class.